study about the fossils, we can call them as paleontologists, and the study is called paleontology. Okay, now let's go to the astrophysics. What is about the astrophysics? The person who is interested to take the photographs or to shoot the photographs of space, not you. Okay, photographs of the distant galaxies. If you see the space, we find different type of bodies like sun, star, moon, galaxies, right? So to shoot the photos or to know what is present in the universe, to analyze about the particular bodies, the person who is very interested here called as astrophysicist. He is giving the information about the distant galaxies and their photographs. You can see these photographs in the TV, like natural geographical channel, or in the newspaper you can see, and different type of books you can see, right? So like that. So here next goes to the climatologist. See here, if you see outside, you can see very cool, the temperature, it is drizzling now, but we don't know what is happening in other places, right? So to know that information, some of the people are coming forward to give the information what is happening, weather condition, forecasting of the weather. You have studied in 7th class that meteorological department will give the information about weather forecasting. So that some of the persons are interested to know what is happening according to the weather or the nature and the environment. Those all are interested to show by the scientist called as climatologist. He will collect the data from the weather balloon. So they will get the information. So they will provide information. We can see in the newspapers, we can see in the TV channels, the current information, wherever what is happening, like that. Okay, next one. So these all the informations are observed, children. So in before class we have discussed science is an observation. Okay, observational science. By observation we can get different type of information. So this is called as observational science. So they have given this information. So next, coming towards the experimental science. Science is also experiment. It is a real thing, right? Until unless experiment, do the experiment, we cannot understand some of the concepts, right? So here chemistry is one of the scientists who is interested in the chemistry, where they will give the information how the reactions are going on, how one of the reactant is combining with the one more and giving the product, right? So that how the new substance is giving in that particular reaction, and how far the temperature is going on when they are reacting, those all are given by this chemist. In this chemist we can find the observation along with the experiment. Means here this is related to the science of observation as well as an experiment. Next one, nuclear physics will give you information about angular momentum of a circular cloth. For this example you can take where the earth is rotating and revolving, right, both around the sun and itself. So this is also in the form of circular path. So this information, as we don't know, yes, you learn this one in the social also. So this information is given by the particular scientists who are very interested in the nuclear physics. So like this, next go for biology. Biology is given about the living organisms, plants, animals, human beings, all those, and their internal structures. What is happening? How they works? Right here, depending upon this particular subject only, you people are very interested to show the models of the biology. Like you can take kidney, how heart works, how brain is working. So when a science fair held in any particular school, you people will show the concept working model, right? So means here these are giving information by the biologist. Next one, you go for pathologist. What is meant by pathologist? Disease causing organism, we have learnt in lesson microorganisms. Disease causing organism is called as pathology. So studying about that particular is called as pathology. So scientists we can call it as pathologist. How the disease is transmitted from one person to other person. Now you can take current situation is corona. How it is transmitting from one person to other person. So they given some precautions as we are following them when we are saving our lives, right? So who given this particular precautions? First of all, so some of the people who knows, who go for research, who go for experiment, all those, they can understand how that particular organism will transfer from one person to other person. So that is done by your pathologist. Next, we'll go for earth scientist here. Earth scientist here, what is happening on the earth? We don't know, as we are living. But have you seen, have you heard, I think so, in the television, or they will give the information that may get earthquake, right? Or volcanic eruption. So and so current in current affairs you can see clearly that they will give alarm time that come out, you can move from particular place, you can save your lives, they will give information, right? So how they can know that information? Who are interested in the dealing with the earth, the scientists can know about that, so they will give some information so to save our lives. So next goes to the geneticist. What is meant by geneticist? Here in your family you can see you are related to your parent, like father or mother. How it happens? Because of the transferring of characters from your mother to you or father to your brother, right? That we don't know. So that characters, how you pass from one generation to the other generation, will be said by the geneticist. These are all the scientists who came forward, which are related to science. These are all different branches of science. Not only you are learning about only physics, chemistry and biology, so and so, but only not these three. So these are all also come under the branch of science. So different scientists come forward and give information about the science. So here, now next coming to the intermediate perspective and the societal perspective. What is meant by perspective? So way of learning something or way of something new of related to the science. This is what type of an attitude to gain some knowledge, that is individually and what is societal. Societal means here group of scientists come forward to give some information to us. So here in individual perspective, what they will do, first of all, what is the problem is there, they will collect the information, they will collect the data and they will find out that information, what is there, and they will give us this, I mean they will give the result, either in the form of discovery you take, invention you take, recovery you take, or if they done old one, if that old one is wrong, if they think that old one is wrong, they will disprove it, disprove that old one, they will create new one, and that new one will be given as a result. So in this way they will discovery a change or discovery of thinking of a nature, and whatever the previous problem is there, that previous problem they won't explain because it is wrong. See here, when they do an experiment, they itself themselves they will try whether this is right or wrong. They will come to know if that is right, then they will give us into the world. Yes, this is right, you can carry on. If it is wrong, they will not give a particular information to us. So like that, individually there is only one particular scientist will come forward to give the information. Like you take in lesson 2 about Robert Hooke, he given the information about the cell, like that. So different type of different scientists, differently their research, and they will give us information. So that come under the individual perspective. Example, you can take about a dinosaur. So in so and so long years back, one of the animal was there, which is a dinosaur, where you have two types. One is vegetarian, one is like they will eat animals. So like this, this different type of species is present on the earth. As we don't know, when the scientists come forward and say about that, then we don't know. So like that, different type of information, like atoms, atoms will collide each other, so they will give the certain changes. So this heat energy is produced. This all information can be given by one of the particular scientists to come forward. Then that is about the individual perspective. Next, coming to the societal perspective here, the name itself says societal means what? Children group. Group of scientists come forward to do any research or invention, or to discover any new things, right? See here, in societal perspective, the scientists who come forward, for them, the resources given to the particular scientist. For example, 5 scientists are there. To that 5 scientists, the resources has been given. Resources means what here? Like materials required to do an experiment. That resources, without that resources, they cannot do anything, right? So here, to work on science, the society will provide some of the resources to the scientists so that they can do. By that resources, the knowledge of the science will be increased. That's why I said you about the pathogens and the genes, right? So, like that, in an efficient way, they will discover about the petroleum and as well as the ores. Not only one scientist, different scientists will come forward to do any experiment or the research. So, the people who are very interested or who are coming forward with a curiosity, they can do any research. and they can get find the results. So I say that saying like the scientist, if you people are very interested in any doing the work with curiosity or with the eagerness that I want this work, I can do this work, with some of the motivation that I have to get the result from this work. So if that any curiosity if you have, you can do your work and you can get success in your work like a scientist. I hope you will become a scientist in future. So these are about the individual perspective and the societal perspective. Only one point you should remember, children, in individual only one of the scientists will come forward to do any work and to provide new things or discover anything, right? But in the societal, what is happening? Group of scientists coming forward and this to them resources are provided by the government or by any nation, so that they will still provide curiosity to discover the new things and create a new things towards the nation. So this is about today's topic, where we have discovered about the fox of scientists, what they have giving or what they are doing, the tremendous work towards the science. In that way, the science and technology is increasing day by day, and it all continues in the future also. So I hope you have understood. Please note all the points what we have discussed, then after completion of session recap it, so little more you can get the information. Thank you, children.